Welcome to the Squeeze Trigger Report for Tuesday, February 20th. I'm your host, Tom Ronk, founder and CEO of SqueezeTrigger.com. We're going to start our show off today talking about market direction. We'll look at the Dow and the NASDAQ and see how they're holding up. Then we'll go over to OmniTrader and see if we still have our long signals on both the Dow and the NASDAQ. We'll go over to VisualTrader and recap Friday's trading in 15-minute bars. We'll go over to market history seasonal edge indexes. So we're going to look at all the different indexes and see which ones tend to do better or worse from February 20th on. Then we're going to go over and look at our short squeezes with Squeeze Trigger. We're going to look at those that are crossing above their Squeeze Trigger price now, and we'll set some alerts. Then we're going to take a look at market history trade ideas. We'll look at several different trade ideas. They've been working out well. We'll go over to Earnings Edge. There's a lot of company with earnings reports coming out today, and we'll look at see which ones have a tendency to do best just after their earnings report. Then we'll go to Seasonal Edge and see which stocks have the tendency to fare best from February 20th on. We'll go over to Commodities Edge and do the same. We want to see which commodity futures tend to do better from February 20th on. Then we'll go to Currency Edge and see which of the 45 different trading pairs seem to do best from February 20th on. And we'll finish up with Pattern Scan today, and we have a new arm free trade. The Dow traded slowly sideways throughout the session on Friday and continues to hold at overall highs above the key 12,700 resistance level. The OmniTrader chart shows we're still long and we're above the long-term trend line. The VisualTrader 15-minute chart shows a slight sell-off in the morning that turned into afternoon strength, with the Dow closing up 2 points to 12,767. We're still long the Dow, and we're going to add the positions above 12,800, and we're going to use 12,720 as our short-term stop. The NASDAQ opened Friday's session lower, but slowly climbed higher the rest of the session. The OmniTrader chart shows we're still long, and we're above both the short-term and the long-term trend lines. The VisualTrader 15-minute chart shows the morning weakness and then the steady climb the rest of the day. The NASDAQ closed unchanged at 2496. We're going to add to our positions above 2505, and we're going to use 2480 as our short-term stop. Let's go over now and look at market history indexes and see which indices tend to do best from February 20th on. We've sorted it by percentage return. Take a look at this. The Amex Airline Index is expected to earn 7.5% over the next 31 trading days. This has happened 10 out of the 12 past years, or 83% of the time. The Philly Oil Service Sector Index is still long here, also expected to earn 7.5% in the next 9 trading days. That's happened 10 out of the 10 past years. Natural Gas Index, also expected to earn 7.5% over the next 28 trading days. That's happened 9 out of the 12 past year. And take a look at the Amex Oil Index, expected to earn just under 4% in the next 28 trading days. That's happened 73% of the time. And if you go down to the bottom, the Amex Biotech Index is expected to lose over 6% in the next 28 trading days. That's happened 79% of the time. So we're still long all our oil and gas sectors here, and Amex Airline Index is new, so you can take a look at some of the airlines here. So let's go over and take a look at our Squeeze Trigger crossover events and Squeeze Trigger alerts for today. Okay, we have two crossover events and one alert to talk to you about today. The way that we arrive at these each morning is we go to www.squeezetrigger.com, we click on strategies, we click on Squeeze Trigger, and up pops a list of all stocks crossing up above one of their Squeeze Trigger levels. We then sort that list by total short interest. We only want those stocks with more than 1 million shares of total short interest. The first one on the list today is Natus Medical. The symbol's BABY. 1.55 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze Trigger price is $13.67. Stocks at $16.10. $25 million needs to cover. We have a $20 price target on baby. If you look back in 05, you have anywhere up to about $20-25 million a month being shorted. Same thing in 06, up in the $20-25 million a month level. So this is a stock that's not one of our favorites, but it did make the list. The next one is one of our favorites. It's Boyd Gaming. The symbol is BYD. 4.2 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze trigger price is 45.13. Stocks at 48.66. $204 million needs to cover. We've got a $55 price target on BYD. You look back in 05, you had up to a half a billion dollars a month being shorted. You get into 06, gets up to almost $600 million a month being shorted. So BYD is one of our favorites. You can buy it now with a target of 55. The one alert we have today is United Therapeutics, 2.5 million shares of total short interest. The symbol's UTHR, by the way. The squeeze trigger price is $56.85. The current price is $53.93, so it's got about three more bucks it's going to go. But when it does get above $56.85, there's $137 million that needs to cover. We'll have a $61 price target on UTHR. Back in 05, you had anywhere up to $350 million a month being shorted. Same thing in 06. So, like I said, you can't buy it yet, but when UTHR gets above 56.85, it'll be a good buy. So our favorite today is Boyd Gaming, BYD. Take a look at the chart that I put in front of you, then we'll go to a commercial break.
Tired of losing money in the market? Would you like to know which stocks could be positioned for big gains? Buyins.net has the answer. When traders bet a stock will drop in price, they sell it short. If they bet wrong and the stock rises, they buy it back to cover their losses. It's called a short squeeze and can create a demand for a stock and drive the price higher. Buyins.net created Squeeze Trigger to identify short squeezes in real time.
This information was one of Wall Street's most closely guarded secrets until recently, and Buyins.net is the only place you can get it. We monitor the market and alert you when your stock crosses its squeeze trigger price. All you have to do is pull the trigger.
You can monitor up to 10 stocks for just $9.95 a month, or for only $19.95 a month, we'll monitor the entire market for you in real time. That's over 15,000 stocks, and alert you to the ones that are crossing their squeeze trigger price. It's that easy. Call 1-800-715-9999 or visit www.buyins.net to unlock the secrets of Wall Street today.
Welcome back. We have several market history trade ideas to go over today. The first one is Unit Corp. The symbol is UNT. How has UNT performed in the past, omitting repeat occurrences within 10 trading days, when during the first quarter, it has seen a decline of less than 1% after experiencing a trend day down the day before? Answer: according to the 10 previous occurrences of this event, Event Edge indicates that UNT has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 35 trading days after the event. It rallies 90% of the time by an average of 17% relative to the close on the event date. The average of the one decline is down 6.5%, and the overall return in the 10 cases is 14.7%. So a nice little move we're expecting on UNT. The next one is Ross Stores. The symbol's ROST. How have shares in Ross performed in the past when they have seen a very big one-day gain on a day when the stock crosses into new 52-week high territory? Answer: according to the 18 previous occurrences of this event, Event Edge indicates that Ross has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 24 trading days after the event. It rallies 89% of the time by an average of 12.5% relative to the close on the event date. The average of the two declines is down 5.9%, and the overall return in the 18 cases is 10.5%. The next one's Acergy. The symbol's ACGY. How has ACGY performed in the past after February 15th? According to the eight previous occurrences of this event, Event Edge indicates that ACGY has shown a very strong bullish edge that peaks 23 trading days after the event. It rallies 8 out of 8 times, 100% of the time, by an average of 14.9% relative to the close on the event date. The next is Focus Media. The symbol's FMCN. How has FMCN performed in the past after a big down day after an all-time high? Answer: According to the 8 previous occurrences of this event, it's shown a very strong bullish edge that peaks 11 trading days after the event. It rallies 100% of the time by an average of 11.9% relative to the close on the event date. And we have an option trading strategy associated with this. So the March 80-90 call spread, the QOHCP, QOHCR, in FMCM was trading at 420 at the end of Friday's session, with the stock trading at 81.66. The large bullish edge of 11.9% or $9.74 in FMCN shares offers a potential reward of $5.80 on a $4.20 investment in the call option. So we like the March 80-90 call spread on FMCM. The next one's Tyco, TYC. How has TYC performed in the past when it experiences a MACD bearish crossover on a day with a trend day decline, followed by a rally when it's trading above the 200-day moving average? Answer, according to the 10 previous occurrences of this event, omitting any repeat occurrences within 40 trading days, TYC has shown a very strong bullish edge that peaks 97 trading days after the event. It rallies 10 out of 10 times, or 100% of the time, by an average of 18% relative to the close on the event date. We also have an option trading strategy on TYC. The April 30-35 call spread, it's the TYCDF, TYEDG, was trading at 2.25 last week, with TYC at 31.86. The bullish edge of 18% over the next 40 trading days in TYC could put this call spread well into the money. It's the potential reward here is 122% when risking the cost of the spread, which is 2.25. So interesting call option spread there on Tyco. The last one is Philadelphia Consolidated. The symbol's PHLY. What's happened to PHLY's value since 1995, when it's had a rally immediately after a trend day decline while remaining above the 50-day moving average and the MACD indicator remains bullish? Answer, according to the 20 previous occurrences of this event, omitting any repeat occurrences within 70 trading days, Event Edge indicates that PHLY has shown a very strong bullish edge that peaks 45 trading days after the event. It rallies in 100% of the cases, that's 20 out of 20 times, by an average of 13.4% relative to the close on the event day. All right, we got a lot of earnings reports to go over today, so we're going to break these charts down into whether or not they're releasing before or after the bell today, and we're only going to look at those with 12-quarter or 12-quarter and 6-quarter edges. So the first one's Hewlett-Packard, the symbol's HPQ. They release after the bell today. They've got a 12-quarter and a 6-quarter edge, so you can pull up and buy some shares of HPQ. Next one's Altel Corporation. The symbol is AT. They announced before the bell today. They got a 12-quarter edge, so go check the news. If the stock's up, you can buy it for follow-through. The next one's Elan Corporation. The symbol's ELM. They've got a 12-quarter edge. They announced before the bell today. If they have earnings that are good and their stock's up, when you go check it right now, you can buy ELM. Next one, Century Aluminum, the symbol is CENX, has a 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge they announced after the bell today. So take a look at CENX in after hours. If the stock's up, you can buy it. HCC Insurance Holdings, the symbol is HCC, 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge they also announced after the bell today. Let's move to the next chart here. Northeast Utilities has a 12-quarter edge they announced after the bell today. BioMarin Pharmaceutical has a 12-quarter and a 6-quarter edge they announced before the bell. Go check BMRN right now. If the stock's up, you can buy it. Next one's West Pharmaceutical Services. The symbol's The next one is West Pharmaceutical Services. They've got a 12-quarter edge they announced before the bell. Next one's DeToro Corp, TTC, 12-quarter and a February edge they announced before the bell. So go check it out. If it's doing well, you can buy it. Tanger Factory Outlet Centers, SKT, 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge, they announced after the bell. All right, going to the next chart, we've got American Woodwork Corp, AMWD, has a 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge, they announced before the bell. Equity One, EQY, has a 12-quarter edge, they announced after the bell. Prepaid Legal, PPD, has a 12-quarter edge, they announced after the bell. GTX Incorporated, GTXI, has a 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge, they announced before the bell. And on the last chart here, we don't have any with a 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge, so we're going to go right into earnings reports that are coming out in late February or sometime in March. And we have two charts. The first one, we like JER Investors Trust, JRT, 12-quarter and 6-quarter edge. They announced February 23rd. You can feel free to go buy it now. Next chart, we have Comfort Systems, the symbol's FIX. 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced February 28th. We like that. Linktone, LTOM, 12 quarter and 6 quarter edge, they announced March 8th. We like it. And Famous Daves of America, DAVE, has a 12 quarter edge, they announced February 28th. All right, let's move over to seasonal edge. These are stocks that have a tendency to do well from February 20th on. We've sorted it by their percentage return expected. Priceline, PCLN, over the next 29 trading days, they're expected to earn 23%. This has happened 7 out of the past 7 years. AC Moore Arts and Crafts, ACMR, expected to earn 16.5% over the next 26 trading days. That's happened 8 out of the 9 past years. EchoStar, DISH is a symbol, expected to earn just under 16% over the next 21 trading days. That's happened 82% of the time in the last 11 years. Omni Energy Services, OMNI, expected to earn just under 16% over the next 30 trading days. That's happened 8 out of the 9 past years. Let's look at the flip side of this. These are stocks that have a seasonal tendency to do poorly from February 20th on. Insight Genomics, INCY, over the next 31 trading days, expected to lose around 23%. That's happened 12 out of the 13 past years. AVI Biopharma, AVII, over the next 26 trading days, expected to lose just under 20%. That's happened 8 out of 9 past years. Regeneron Pharmaceuticals, REGM, expected to lose 16.5% over the next 31 trading days. And Faro Technologies, FARO, expected to lose just over 15% in the next 23 trading days. That's happened 89% of the time. Now, I want you to see a correlation here. We told you that the Amex Biotechnology Index is expected to be down almost 6.75% from here going forward based on its seasonality. And then look at all these 3 out of the 4 I just mentioned are all biotech or pharma. So this is a weak time of the year for biotech and pharma. Let's go over and look at commodities. Energy still running here. Natural gas futures expected to earn 14% in the next 29 trading days. That's happened 75% of the time, or 12 out of the 16 past year. So we like nat gas here. Heating oil futures expected to earn almost 9% in the next 31 trading days. That's happened 22 out of 28 past years. Brent crude oil futures expected to earn over 4% in the next 9 trading days. So take a look at all of that. Those energy futures are still looking great. All right, let's move over to currencies. Russian ruble per the U.S. dollar, meaning that the dollar is expected to get strong against the ruble by almost 8% in the next 31 trading days. That's happened 7 out of the 9 past year. Dollar is supposed to get stronger against the Italian lira by over 2% in the next 23 trading days. That's happened 78% of the time. U.S. dollar is supposed to get stronger against Greek drachmas. That's happened 1.6% of the time in the next. It's expected to gain 1.6% over the next 23 trading days. That's happened 71% of the time. And the dollar is supposed to get stronger against the South African rand as well. All right, lots of charts to talk to you about today. Well, let's take a look at pattern scans for short term. Remember, we're looking for strategies that show a long signal, a buy signal, and then have it confirmed by a green bullet. That means it's a positive or bullish pattern direction, and a strength rating of 4 or 5, 5 being the best. So SYNM, we like it. Good strategy, 5 strength rating, and it's got a long signal, so we like that. Next one's THS, same thing, except it's got a 4 strength rating. IOTN has a long signal, 4 strength rating, green bullet. DKS has a long signal, 4 strength rating, green bullet. DTPI, also 4 strength rating, green bullet. SAFM, same thing. TARR, same thing. And PAY, so those all look good there. All right, we got a couple of long-term pattern scans to look at. LPNT has a 5 strength rating and a green bullet with a long strategy. MOGN, same thing, but it's got a 4 strength rating. SAFM has a 4 strength rating, and PAYX has a 4 strength rating. So some good long-term charts going there as well. All right, let's break it down by some individual charts. First thing is a New York Stock Exchange short-term trade. GMR, we like. Brand new long signal. It's a swing trade breaking out to a new high. We like GMR. Next one, a New York Stock Exchange long-term trade, WellPoint Health Network, WLP, was a long rating back in late November. We just got reiterated here as it's breaking out to a new high. It's a trend trade, so we like WLP. All right, short-term NASDAQ trade, we like BUCY. It's a swing trade. It was a long signal middle of last week. It got reiterated over the weekend. It's breaking out to a new high. You can buy BUCY. Another NASDAQ short-term trade is to sell Amgen. This is a big stock here, but look at how it's breaking down. It went up from 77 down to 66. Remember, bad time of the year for biotechs. Look at how poorly Amgen's doing. You might want to pull money off the table short-term here and wait for it to be a buy later on. So it's a brand new sell. It's a swing trade. Steer clear of AMGM. Next one is a long signal NASDAQ long-term trade. It's OTEX. We're reiterating this one. We've been long for a couple of days. It's a breakout to a new high. We like OTEX. Next one is NASDAQ long-term trade, COHR, brand new long signal here. This is a stock that dropped from 38 down to around just under 30. It's turning around here, so we're calling the bottom in COHR. Another long signal. This is a pattern scan NASDAQ short-term trade, PRAA. It's a swing trade. It was a long on Thursday, reiterated on Friday, breaking out to a new high. We like Portfolio Associates, PRAA. All right, we got a pattern scan NASDAQ long-term trade, sell DVSA. DiversiCorp's looking poor, broke down below support. It's a trend trade. It's reversed the trend. It's a brand new sell signal. Steer clear of DVSA. And our ARM3 trade for today is Fossil, F-O-S-L. It's broken out to a new high here above resistance. It's a brand new long signal over the weekend. You can buy F-O-S-L. So, like I said, while we're going through tax and accounting season, we're going to come to you about once a week. If you want to check into these technologies and how our trades are doing meantime, Tuesday through Friday, we have all of these technologies available at SqueezeTrigger.com. You can get SqueezeTrigger reports for $19.95 a month. OmniTrader, you can buy for a one-time fee of $4.95, and then you can subscribe to pattern scans for $49.95 a month and do everything I'm doing here. And market history simply is one of the best technologies out there for predicting what's going to happen in the future across all trading instruments. You can sign up for a free 1 month there. You just go to strategies and click on market history. So all of the things I'm teaching you to do every day, you can do yourself, and we'll just keep training you on how to do this because it's working out. So hopefully we'll see you one more time this week. If not, we'll catch up with you next Monday. I'm your host, Tom Ronk, signing out.